Using the government's figures, only 8,000 are recorded as COVID deaths. That leaves 10,000 additional and unexplained care home deaths this April. Now, I know the government must have looked into this. So can the Prime Minister give us the government's views on these unexplained deaths?
The Office of National Statistics is responsible for producing the data that they have. The government has also produced data which not only shows that there has been, as I say, a terrible epidemic in care homes, but since the COVID, since the Care Homes Action Plan began, we are seeing an appreciable and substantial reduction, not just in the number of outbreaks, but also in the number of deaths.
Yesterday, the government stopped publishing the international comparison and the slide is gone. Why?
The UK has been going through an unprecedented, once-in-a-century epidemic, and he seeks to make comparisons with other countries, which I'm advised are premature, because the correct and final way of making these comparisons will be when we have all the excess death totals for all the relevant countries.
The problem with the Prime Minister's answer is it's pretty obvious that for 7 weeks, when we weren't the highest number in Europe, they were used for comparison purposes. As soon as we hit that unenviable place, they've been dropped.
Just on his earlier point about not learning from other countries, nothing could be further from the truth. We are watching intently what is happening in other countries, and it is very notable that in some other countries where relaxations have been introduced, there is the signs of the R going up again.
Mr. Speaker, will the Prime Minister accept that the clear message in Scotland is stay home to protect the NHS to save lives?
The message throughout the country is, of course, that you should stay at home if you can, and unless the specific circumstances that we've outlined apply. But I must say I don't accept the characterisation of the cooperation that we've had across all four nations that the leader of the SNP makes. In my experience, and it's been intense, it's been going on for days and days and weeks and weeks, and actually I think if you look at the totality of the measures that we're taking as a country, there is much more that unites us than divides us, and we will go forward together.